So, first of all, congrats for being back. Glad you guys are back. Congrats to 10 episodes now.
Yeah.
Now, as we're going to season 2, and you know, some, one of the things that was so great about Agent Carter was, you know, the relationship between Angie and Peggy. Now that they're together in a big old Hollywood, what can you tease about their relationship as, you know, like do you see them as sisters as well? Like, you know, that type of relationship, and what can you, like, tease about in this season?
I love them the first season together. They have this wonderful kind of friendship that sort of like to explore that. We hope that you will be able to spend the time together. The fact is we don't know if you can take them. So, but we just want to be super dramatic.
I was actually going to say the relationship I look for in Agent Carter was actually Peggy and Jarvis. I thought that their rapport and the banter that they had was amazing. I'm very glad that he got listed as a series regular. So,
their relationship is sort of...
They're amazing.
The core, quickly learned it was the heart of the show.
Yes, absolutely.
So, the nice thing about moving it to LA is there's a really organic way to include Jarvis by using Howard Stark. So Howard, we're saying, moved to LA because that's where the tech industry is starting up, or like, you know, the atomic industry is starting up. So I said, well, I'll do some contract work for government, and then I'll open up a movie studio, direct some films. So Jarvis is there setting up his estate in Beverly Hills, which is like a Playboy mansion meets Neverland with like flamingos and chicks in bikinis, like our interns. I'm with you. It's like that. As soon as we saw them together, we're like, let's try and do that as much as we can. The Peggy story and Peggy getting flip at work about that we've told, but it's not that 1947 sex no longer exists. Great. But it will just tell you.
I think there's so different perspectives about back then how women used their power.
Yeah.